Hi, I'm Tom Patterson. I'm the managing director at Accenture for our global quantum security business. And I'm here with our good friend and partner, Robert Williams from SandboxAQ. Robert, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Tom.
You know, this week we're here at the World Economic Forum's annual meeting 2025 here in Davos, Switzerland. And I got to learn to say that. And here in Davos, we were able to talk to a wide variety of technologies. But one of them is AI, and another one is quantum. And what we're talking about today, and in a report that we issued jointly here at Davos this week, is on AI's impact on quantum security. I thought the report delivery yesterday went really well.
Absolutely.
And nice group of people, nice group of interest. Up and down the promenade, we're seeing a lot of interest in both AI and quantum, but we haven't seen so many people looking at them in a combined way, looking at how one impacts the other. And it turns out with this report, there's a lot of interaction.
Yes, it is.
So in this report that we co-authored, we really focused on three areas. The first area is impacts that help. So where does AI help quantum security? Then we went to the flip side of that coin, where does AI hurt? And then finally, we looked at the timing. How does AI affect the timing of the whole quantum security industry? So let's start with the how does it help? You know, we went through, I think we cataloged 10 different ways that AI has a positive impact on quantum security. You know, did any of them stand out to you?
Absolutely, Tom. So AI and quantum together create business transformation outcomes for many industries, healthcare, life sciences, government, and others. There's a tremendous opportunity to help in terms of quantum security. So one example is discovering your cryptographic assets. So they're everywhere from a cloud standpoint, networks, servers. How do you find them? How do you profile them the right way? And then where do you know where to focus in terms of the high risk elements that potentially can be the low hanging fruit for a bad actor? AI helps with all of that.
That's a great point. And your new product actually helps Accenture bring that to our clients much more efficiently. Mm-hmm. It used to be a very laborious process. You know, a lot of humans doing a lot of deep diving. Now, not only do you have discovery, but you've added the AI back end to do that post-processing. It really makes a big difference. So that's definitely one area out of the 10 that the report highlights that really helps positively impact. Like I said, there's a flip side to everything. Yes. And so there is also negative impacts that come with AI on quantum security. Let me ask you again, Robert, what stood out in the report to you there?
Yes, bad actors are always looking for the low-hanging fruit. So being able to simulate a client's environment and figure out where they can get into the network most efficiently and at the accelerated pace and then move laterally across the network. So they're using AI tools just like we use them for good.
And we're seeing that today.
And we're seeing that today, unfortunately, across many industries.
And which makes it even more important to use positive impacts of AI
Absolutely.
To counter those negative impacts. So
Absolutely.
We're definitely seeing that. I'm also seeing what I thought in the report really stood out to me was that adversaries are now using AI to come up with better targeting algorithms against quantum or against security. So we're seeing instead of relying on a 20-year-old Shor's algorithm, we're now relying on a 20-minute-old AI version of Shor's that's actually more efficient. So the bad guys are using it. We got to make sure the good guys can use it. Now, the big question that everyone has up and down the promenade and throughout the forum this year is really when. When is this going to hit? When is this going to be impactful? Why are we talking about it here today on the promenade? And so the report, again, really highlighted a number of things, including our new calculator that Accenture built with MIT. Do you guys use that with your clients?
Yes, absolutely. We see the risk now of stealing now and decrypting later in terms of bad actors taking the data. So we're helping them understand that they need to move now, and the calculator really helps with that.
Yeah, the big thing that really stood out for us and the respondents on the report was that it wasn't just someone guessing when this is going to be relevant. We went through with every technology breakthrough and all the different types of quantum advances that are happening, what adversaries are doing with them, the combination of quantum and GPU farms that are doing these hybrid attacks. We looked at all that and built that into a calculator so anyone can go. It's open source at MIT. You can go and put in what you believe, and then you'll get the dates that matter most to you. So we're taking the guesswork out of the when.
Absolutely.
But really, what does it come down to? I mean, there are a number of recommendations that we ended the report with about what should people be doing. What's next up? They've seen the good. They've learned about the bad. Yes. They've figured out a way to look at the actual problem scientifically in terms of when know, what's next for people?
Frankly, they need to start now. They need to discover their cryptographic assets. Data is everywhere with the prevalence of AI. So we need to start now. We need to understand all the inventory that's out there in terms of cryptography, but leverage the AI and machine learning capabilities to really identify where the risk points are. Leverage the Accenture expertise, leverage SandboxAQ's platform as an example. And then once you bring in the experts, then you start to build that plan toward long-term resiliency.
And I think it's a great way to sum it up, Robert. It's really at the highest level here at the forum, when we're looking, you know, with the global leaders and really helping to change the world here, what we're talking about is let's take a look at quantum and separately the look at AI, and now let's start to look at bringing them together and looking how we can use them in a positive way. That's what the report is all about.
Absolutely.
That's what this week was all about for our two companies. Mm-hmm. I thought it went great. We had good weather here in Davos for the first time. So absolutely. So I hope anyone can download the report on either of our websites, go to the MIT site and use the calculator. It's listed in the report. And start now.
Thank you.
Thank you.